Hello everybody, welcome to our video tutorials. In this video, we show you how to use Telegram Mapper software in order to create a custom data point list to use in your application. Go to woodward.com, log into your account and search for Telegram Mapper. Click on the Telegram Mapper installer and download it. Install the program on your computer and run it. Run the program on your PC. In the menu files, you have several options. Set package, which defines the application for which the mapping shall be done. For example, an easygen-3200XT-P1 or an easygen-3500XT-P2. If there is already a mapping file, it can be loaded by selecting the Load Mapping menu item. A loaded or created mapping file can be saved as a file by selecting the Files, Save Mapping menu item. The file type is MAP. Create mapping files, which will create MAP, HTML, and SCP files to use later. Help menu, which will display the help document. Click on the Set Package, and choose your zip file. Package files might be obtained from industrial support, or you can download them directly from the memory of your easygen-3000XT unit. When the package is set, you can make your own mapping of the Modbus for easygen-3000XT. You can add constant values, analog manager values, logics manager values, index values, or separator lines. For the data types, we support a wide selection of types. Telegram Mapper also supports big and little endian byte order. You can read more about the values and data types in the help document shown here. Now you can create your custom mappings file. Remember to set the protocol number. It should be 65100 to 65199. Now we create a test value which we later read from our easygen-3000XT unit. The constant will be, for example, 888. Let's note the address at which we created the 888 value. After entering your custom data points, you can create SCP, XML and MAP files with creating mapping files option. Now we can see these three files: SCP file to flash your easygen, MAP file to edit later in Telegram Mapper, and HTML file to check your custom protocol in an internet browser. This is how the HTML file looks like. It contains a date, protocol number, and all the values entered. Now, flash your unit with a newly created SCP file. After flashing the easygen with the newly created custom protocol SCP file, we need to configure the easygen. Connect to your controller. Enter the password. You can find more on the password system in the technical manual. Go to Parameters. Configure Interfaces. Modbus Protocol. Change the number of the protocol to correspond to your customized number. After changing the protocol number, remember to reboot the unit. Now we check and mod scan our test constant in connected easygen. EasyGen responds correctly, everything works. This is all for now. Please check out our other training videos as well.